Let's talk again about the Megmeet indoor circuit. You've probably watched the first part, and I hope you understood it. So let's pick up from where we left off. I was explaining that after you've checked the high side and I've told you all the points, if everything seems fine but the voltages still aren't being produced, where could the problem lie? There's a grounding capacitor installed. If there's an issue with the grounding capacitor, the 12 volt won't appear on the low side. I'll show you the capacitor, CY4. You'll need to check CY4 to ensure it hasn't shorted due to any reason. If it has, replace it, and you should get 12 volts. Additionally, there's another capacitor installed for filtering, EC3. The chopper generates the voltage here, and this capacitor filters it. It's connected to the ground. If it becomes faulty for any reason, you'll also face disturbances in the voltage. Another potential issue could be a resistor installed here. This is a 10-ohm resistor that acts like a fuse. Let me show you the resistor from another side. This resistor is rated at 10 ohms, and its number is R19. If it fails, you won't get 12 volts either. If you're getting 12 volts on one side of this point, but not on the other, this resistor has likely gone bad. Now, there's a voltage regulator installed. On the left side, this is its input. The center pin is ground, and the third pin is the output. You should get 5 volts at the output. If you're not getting 5 volts, it means the voltage regulator has likely failed for some reason. On the PCB, it's labeled U3, and it's a 7805 series voltage regulator. If this fails, it will cause the problem as well. Now, even if you're getting 5 volts at this point, but the PCB still isn't powering on, I'll guide you on where else to check the voltages. Let's first talk about the 12 volts. Why are the 12 volts used here? Look, the 12 volts generated here are also converted to 5 volts, but the 12 volts are also used for other purposes. Look at the two ULN2003 ICs installed here. These are Darlington arrays, and they're used for two things: switching the relay and controlling the stepper motor, which manages the swing and airflow. Now, if you're getting 5 volts at this point, but the PCB is still not powering on, I'll explain what other issues could be causing the problem. Look at this point, FB1, it's a fuse. If this fuse blows, the microcontroller won't receive any supply. And if the microcontroller doesn't get the supply, the whole unit won't turn on. So it's necessary to check this point. Additionally, there's capacitor number 13 here. If you're not getting 5 volts at capacitor 13, the problem could be with FB1. So check it to ensure that 5 volts are reaching here. Also, look at capacitor C98. You should be getting 5 volts at this point. If not, you'll need to investigate why 5 volts aren't reaching here. There's a transistor labeled U2, and next to it is a capacitor labeled C8. You should be getting 8 volts at this point. If 8 volts aren't present, the feedback connection won't work, and there will be an issue. So, you'll need to check this area for feedback-related problems. Now, let me explain what could be the reason if the blower motor isn't working. The zero crossing voltages need to be correct at this point. There's an optocoupler labeled HP2, which is used for zero crossing detection. Additionally, if transistor Q2 is faulty, this can also cause the problem. Look here at capacitors C27 and C33. If you're not getting 5 volts at these capacitors, the blower motor won't work either. Also, if resistor RJ19 is faulty, the blower motor won't function. Furthermore, if the blower motor isn't working, check this switching IC and the 100-ohm resistor installed here. If these components fail, the blower motor will stop working as well. If the blower motor is running slowly, a faulty capacitor could be the reason. Now, you need to check if the sensors aren't working. There should be 5 volts at both of these points. These are the two points where the sensors are connected. One point is grounded, and the other is the positive point. You should be getting 5 volts at this positive point. If there are no 5 volts, this could also cause the issue, and the sensors won't function properly, leading to problems. Now, let's talk about communication. This whole setup is for communication. It includes optocouplers, capacitors, resistors, and Zener diodes, all serving this purpose. Additionally, there's a resistor here. Look at this. This is a series resistor rated at 8.2 ohms, which receives high voltage input. After this, the optocouplers HP2 and HP3 are connected. These two communicate with the microcontroller. One receives a signal, while the other sends it. This is how they work together. If these Zener diodes fail, the communication will be affected. Moreover, if capacitor EC6 is faulty, that could also lead to issues. If there's absolutely no communication, the PTC sensor labeled as 1 is installed here. There's a higher chance that this sensor has failed because it's designed to protect the system. If there are fluctuations and high voltages, it heats up and can burn out, protecting the rest of the PCB. when checking this circuit, and if the outdoor unit board is not attached to it, there should be 24 to 25 volts at the capacitor EC6. If these voltages are present, it's perfectly fine. And then when you attach it to the outdoor unit, it will communicate properly. If you're not getting that voltage, check the resistors, Zener diodes, and the optocouplers to ensure the communication system is functioning. I hope you've learned a lot about this PCB. See you in the next informative video. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.